Hello students, in our today's lecture we will continue with our previous lectures in which we discussed idioms. Today we will continue with some more idioms. As I have already discussed with you that idioms are phrases which people use in everyday language which do not make sense literally, but we understand what they mean. So let us today begin with some more idioms. The very first one is a fair hand. It means a clear and beautiful handwriting. Fair hand means clear and beautiful handwriting. So the sentence according to this idiom is, the students who write a fair hand often secure good marks in the examination. Or the fair-handed students often obtain good marks in the examination. Next idiom is a cool head. A cool head means a calm and balanced mind. India and Pakistan should find ways and means to solve the Kashmir issue with a cool head. Cool head means a calm and balanced mind. We can also make the sentence that both of those brothers should find ways and means to solve their issue regarding property with a cool head. Next idiom is a maiden speech. A maiden speech means first speech. Her maiden speech was a grand success. Or we can also use it in sentence as, the maiden speech of Prime Minister was a grand success. Next idiom is a necessary evil. That means unavoidable evil. It is a well-known fact that examinations are a necessary evil. Students think it that the examinations are a necessary evil. Next is a walkover. A walkover means a victory gained without any real competition. A victory gained without any real competition. The Congress had a walkover as the opposition parties withdraw their candidate. The Congress had a walkover as the opposition parties withdrew their candidate. Next idiom is a leap in the dark. This is very important idiom. Leap in the dark. It means to take a step without prior thinking or to take a step without forethought. His marriage with an actress was a leap in the dark. Or we can use it in sentence as, his admission in M.Tech was like a leap in the dark. Next idiom is at cross purposes. It means open enmity. At cross purposes means open enmity. India and Pakistan are still at cross purposes over the Kashmir issue. Or we can use it in a sentence as, both of those brothers are at cross purposes over the issue of their property. Next is a square meal. Square meal means a full meal. Means many poor people in our country do not get even a square meal these days. Many poor people in our country don't get even a square meal these days. Next idiom is an oily tongue. It means flattering tongue. Some employees try to please their boss with an oily tongue. Oily tongue means flattering. Some employees try to please their boss with an oily tongue. Or we can make a sentence that some people get promotion by with the help of their oily tongue. Next is a screw loose. It means unbalanced mind. Do not mind what my elder brother says, because he has a screw loose in his head. Do not mind what my elder brother says, because he has a screw loose in his head. Next idiom is a man of parts. It means a man of sterling genius. It is a well-known fact that Jawaharlal Nehru was a man of parts. A wolf in sheep's clothing. This is very important idiom. A wolf in sheep's clothing. It means a cheat. We should beware of some sadhus, as they are wolves in sheep's clothing. At a premium, highly valued. Virtue is at a discount, and vice is at a premium these days. A cat's paw means a puppet. The poor husband is a cat's paw in the hands of his pretty wife. The poor husband is a cat's paw in the hands of his pretty wife. Next is a live wire. Important idiom, a live wire. It means an energetic person. He is really a live wire, as we always find him active. Next is a silver spoon in one's mouth. A silver spoon in one's mouth. It means to be born in a rich family. This is very important idiom. A silver spoon in one's mouth. To be born in a rich family. He was born with a silver spoon in his mouth and was brought up in the lap of luxury. He was born with a silver spoon in his mouth and was brought up in the lap of luxury. Next is at the end of one's tether, means without resources. Both India and Pakistan felt at the end of their tether after the 1971 war. Next is a left-handed compliment. A left-handed compliment means showing little respect. Times have changed, and the modern people pay a left-handed compliment to the elderly people. A fish out of water. Left-handed compliment, it means showing little respect. Times have changed, and the modern people pay a left-handed compliment to the elderly people. Next is a fish out of water. It means, this is very important idiom, a fish out of water. It means restless or uncomfortable. When I joined MPhil in Punjabi University, I felt there as a fish out of water without my parents. Next is a tall talk. It means a great boost. Next idiom is a tall talk. It means a great boost. You should do something practical instead of indulging in a tall talk. You should do something practical instead of indulging in a tall talk. Next idiom is a bit of one's mind. It means a serious rebuke to scold someone seriously. I must someday give my son a bit of my mind because he is irregular in his studies. Next is a bull's eye. It means to win a striking advantage. The Congress party hit a bull's eye by winning the 2004 poll or elections. Next is a trump card. It means a victorious expedient. Her face is her thumb card because she can bend anyone to her wishes. Next is a raw deal. It means unfair treatment. It is a raw deal for poor workers to get very low wages. Raw deal means unfair treatment. It is a raw deal for poor workers to get very low wages. So these are the idioms which we have discussed today. Tomorrow we will continue with our next lecture. Thank you very much.